Welcome back to goldfries. In this video, we'll be looking at the Durgod Taurus K320 and the K320 Corona. Yes, two keyboards. I'm holding just one, but thanks to Durgod for sending me two. The second one being the Corona model, nothing to do with the drinks, nothing to do with the virus. Without further ado, let's have a look at these beautiful keyboards. Let's start by going through what's common between these two. As you can see, both of them are the same tenkeyless layout, and what I can tell you is that they look the same, they feel the same, the weight feels the same as well, but from the specs, the Corona model is slightly lighter. These keyboards are with plastic enclosure and internal steel plate, and that explains the heft. Both keyboards are not of a high profile design, and they are not like the floating key design either, as the switches are exposed but not as those you see on floating key design keyboards. Both come with solid rubber feet on four corners, and both have two-stage flip-out feet with rubber tip. Both come with two USB cables. One is a USB A to USB C cable, and the other is a USB C to USB C cable. Both of them also come with a keycap puller. The USB header that's attached to the keyboard is designed to match the grooves, and the keyboard comes with cable routing channels that go either side or straight out. At a glance, they might look the same, but the K320 Corona model comes with lower profile keycaps. Speaking of keycaps, they are both PBT type, so they won't fade away easily. They are also around 1.5 millimeters in thickness, giving it a solid feel. The keycaps on the K320 Corona are translucent, and they are the best looking backlit keycaps I've ever come across. The K320 model, on the other hand, is non-translucent and has impressive clean edge legend. The K320 Corona model's backlight can be adjusted via key combo, and they definitely look great. Customize it all you want or disable it completely. The Durgod keyboards can be customized further by using the Zeus Engine software. Individual keys can be assigned macro, remap, having key combination, and many other features. You can also customize the lighting, enable other features that are available on the keyboards, and creating new profiles to suit your usage, and even assign profile to keys for easy profile switching. That being said, both keyboards are available in a variety of switches. What I have with me here is that the K320 Corona has a Cherry MX Silver, while the K320 is with Cherry MX Brown. The silver is a linear switch like the red, but has 1.2mm pre-travel, which is shorter than the 2mm of the red. The short profile keycaps coupled with the silver switch is an excellent combo, making the K320 Corona great for those of you who want less effort for typing. Regardless of switch type, they felt great as the stems come with dampeners and they reduce the noise from bottom out and top out. Both keyboards are solid in build quality as the keys do not wobble, and keys with stabilizers such as the spacebar does not rattle. Speaking of stabilizers, the stabilizers on both keyboards are very well lubricated. Alright, so that's it for the Durgod Taurus K320 and K320 Corona. Price should be about 100 $400 US. Over in Malaysia, you can browse it on Lazada at RM400+. It is still cheaper than the competitor brands. However, build quality wise, the feel of typing on it and everything else, superb. I'm giving them a gold badge. All right, that's it for this video. Thank you for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.